another day without your smile. Another day just passes
hey.
By.
How you doing?
You look good.
You look good.
How are you? You're so fancy.
How much it means for you to stay right here with me. The time we spend apart will make our love grow stronger. But it hurts so bad I can't take it any longer. I wanna go home with you. I wanna die lying in your arms. I wanna grow old with you. I wanna be looking in your eyes. I wanna be there for you, sharing in everything you do. I wanna grow old with you. Thousand miles between us now, it causes me to wonder how our love tonight remains so strong. It makes our
wrists
right all alone. The time we spend apart will make our love grow stronger. But it hurts so bad I can't take it any longer. I wanna go home with you. I wanna die lying in your arms. I wanna go home with you. I wanna be looking in your eyes. I wanna be there for you, sharing in everything you do. I wanna go.
Oh, it's a book box.
Ooh. Oh, and it's really pretty.
In the beginning, the Word already existed. The Word was with God, and the Word was God.
Baby, I believe something's burning strong between us. It makes it clear to me.
Let's go.
Oh, perfect.
I'm just on this side. Yeah. Did you hold this?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. You're welcome. You're taking the first. Okay. Okay. Ready?
Are the packages delivered?
Yes. We're all set. You got the rings, the vowels.
The rings, the vowels, the songs.
Yep. You got the songs, right?
Yeah.
Well, wait, okay.
Thank you.
For you guys.
Okay.
Yep,
yep. Guys. So, Tim?
Tim.
Just remember, go at a slow pace when we go.
Yeah, I am.
Okay.
I'm going to
watch the group. Gathered here in the sight of God and in the presence of this company to unite Leah and Stephen Holt in holy matrimony. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Thank you, Tim. You may join your hands and you may all be seated. We live in a day where there's much confusion and distortion of marriage. In fact, our society has really made a mess of marriage in recent years. But marriage isn't man's invention. It is something that God had in his plan, and God gave that plan to man in the Garden of Eden. It was confirmed by the Lord Jesus in Cana of Galilee by his own presence at a wedding. It's declared in the scriptures to be honorable among all men. Therefore, it's not to be entered into inadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, soberly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, Leah and Stephen have come to be joined and to unite two hearts and lives, blending all interests, sympathies, and hopes. We're going to sing a hymn, and you should have the lyrics when you come in on your seat, called Bond of Love. We may stand to sing, please. Thank you.
Please be seated. Let us seek the favor and blessing of him who declared that it is not good for man to be alone and provided holy union of marriage. Let's turn to God and ask his blessing on this marriage and this service. Our Father in heaven, we come before you at this joyful time. We come to witness these two as they exchange their vows to one another, and they pledge to unite their hearts, their desires, and their goals into one. Father, I pray that as they do come together in marriage, Lord, that they would have you at the center of their lives. I pray that they would, as the scriptures teach, that Stephen would love his wife as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. I pray for Leah that she would submit herself to her husband in the Lord, as is told to us in the scriptures in Ephesians. We ask your blessing upon this ceremony. We ask your blessing especially upon this marriage. In the name and for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ, we ask it, amen. The objective God has to bring a man and a woman together can be captured in the words in Genesis chapter 2, verse 24. Two important words. It says to leave and to cleave. It says, therefore shall a man leave his father and mother and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall become one flesh. The word cleave is an old word. We don't use it very often, but it means to cling to or to glue yourself to. A successful marriage brings with it leaving. In essence, you leave all other relationships, and the closest one outside of marriage would be that of your parents. And so you're to leave all other relationships, forsake them all, for the sake of coming together to this single one important relationship. That doesn't mean that when you get married, you're no longer a son or a daughter or a friend or a sibling, but it means that you have a new primary responsibility, and that's to your spouse. Stephen and Leah, I encourage you both to think of those words. You are to cling to each other above all others. You're to still honor your father and your mother, but leaving has taken place. And now your new relationship, all other ones are of lesser importance. You still have friends, you still have parents, but your wife should be your best friend. Your husband should be your best friend. There's another word that describes marriage, and it's implied in this verse, and it's to weave, to become one flesh, it says, to take the strands of two lives and to weave them together to form a single fabric. Now, we know that the strength of any fabric is found in the materials that are in that fabric. In Colossians chapter 2, verse 2, we read that their hearts may be encouraged, having been knit together in love. Love is the critical component. And it's not just a love that is spoken of loosely in this world. It's a special kind of love. It's an agape love. It's a love that puts the needs and the desires of the other ahead of your own. It's not a selfish love. It's not a love for self or of self. It's a love of that other person, no matter what the feelings or the circumstances may be. The other component that you need is you need a third person in your marriage. That seems like an odd thing to say, doesn't it? But in Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 12, we read that a cord of three strands is not quickly torn apart. And that third person or that third strand is the Lord Jesus Christ himself. With him woven through your marriage, your lives together, the bond between you will remain strong and cannot be torn apart. Cling to him as individuals. Cling to him as a couple. And the bond between you will be inseparable. I want to encourage you to read the scriptures together. I want to encourage you to read them as individuals, to pray together, to worship together, and to seek to know him better. As you go into marriage, may God bless you, and may you cling to him and be close to him. Stephen, I understand you've written vows to give to Leah.
Yes.
And I'd like you to do that now.
Okay. Leah, our relationship and how we met is far from normal and extremely original. To say that we met on an online Christian chat site over 9 years ago, dated for 4 years, 6 months, and 13 days, And we're engaged for 1 year, 7 months, and 14 days.
You're an accountant, aren't you?
Yes. I love numbers. And now have been married for 261 days is an outstanding friendship and a strong, loving bond. These years have been tough emotionally through the country borders and time zones, our different work shifts and in school, costly trips and other limitations. But those years have also brought so much other growth and joy through the deep conversations and Bible stories that we've had, the hundreds of photos, the trips we've made together, all the movies and TV shows that we've watched, the music shared, and simply just enjoying the time that we had together. Our friendship is one that God prepared, and I'm truly thankful for the journey that has led to this moment. Although it has only been 8 months, we have shared joys and tears, excitement and sadness, happiness and pain. We have learned how and where we work well together and discover what drives the other crazy. I promise to continue to love and adore you with my whole heart, which has been filled with love from God and from you. I promise to continue to support you in our marriage, your walk with God, your relationships with others, in your career, and starting a family. I will remain by your side through the good times and bad. The promises I have made today are for a lifetime. All those years ago, I fell in love with you because of your beautiful heart. Today, above all, I love you the most because of the same beautiful heart.
Thank you, Stephen. Leah, likewise, you have written vows to Stephen.
Yep.
I'd like to give those to you too.
Stephen, I can't believe this day has finally come. When you asked me to marry you in 2014, we had already made so many plans that God had changed. We should have known better than to make more plans. God has had a different plan for us each time. From the very beginning of our friendship, he has always been ahead of us, leading us closer to each other and to him. When I sought Christian friendship online, God provided. I found CCF where I met you. I wondered at the time how someone my age could be so on fire for God. You are always studying your Bible and taking part in lengthy biblical discussions online. We became friends and you encouraged me to read the Bible more and to really study it to find out what it means and how to use it in real life. I was so thrilled to finally find a friend who placed God first in life. It really seemed a rare thing at the time. Could I have imagined then that I would one day marry you? Never. Why ruin a perfectly good friendship with romance? Online relationship? Long distance? No thanks. But again, God had a different plan. We discovered romance was inevitable between us. Of course it was. After praying for months, we finally made it Facebook official. Despite our first objections, we began moving forward as a couple. When God says go, you just go, and we did. And amazing, look where he's brought us. 4.5 years later, mm-hmm. You proposed, and we planned for a colorful fall wedding in October. Still, God had other plans. No matter what happens, God always has something better. I objected to marrying earlier than planned, but again, 6 months later, we were standing together before God, committing to marriage. There's been so many things happened, so many uncertainties, yet God has remained. You are a man of God, Stephen. You meant what you said when you said, I do. You live your life committed to God and to our marriage every day. You are quite often the definition of love in Corinthians 13. Since the day I met you, you have made leaps and bounds in your spiritual walk with Jesus, and you are still leading me toward a life that is committed to following him. God knew I would need a strong spiritual leader, and here you are, proving that God knows what is best. He always does. I have loved being your wife these past few months, and I'm so excited to continue being your wife for the many years ahead. Thank you for asking me to be your friend. Thank you for asking me to be your girlfriend. Thank you for asking me to be your fiance. And thank you for making me your wife. I love you.
Stephen, what pledge do you give of the sincerity of your vows?
A ring.
Leah, do you accept this ring as a pledge of to the sincerity of Stephen's vows?
I do.
Stephen, please repeat after me. This ring I give to you.
This ring I give to you.
As a promise of my love and devotion.
As a promise of my love and devotion.
And as a symbol.
And as a symbol.
Of all that we have promised before God.
Of all that we have promised before God.
And that all that we shall share.
And all that we shall share.
I have joyfully married you.
I have joyfully married you.
And joined my life to yours.
And joined my life to yours.
Leah, what pledge do you give to Stephen as a sincerity of your vows?
A ring.
Please place it on his hand. Stephen, do you accept this ring as a pledge of the sincerity of Leah's vows?
Yes, I do.
Leah, please repeat after me. This ring I give to you.
This ring I give to you.
As a promise of my love and devotion.
As a promise of my love and devotion.
And as a symbol.
And as a symbol.
Of all that we have promised before God.
Of all that we have promised before God.
And all that we shall share.
And all that we shall share.
I have joyfully married you.
I have joyfully married you.
And have joined my life to yours.
And have joined my life to yours.
We are now going to build some sandcastles. Stephen has brought sand from Virginia, from a lake of a place that's familiar to him. And Leah has brought some sand from the beautiful Nova Scotia shoreline. And as a symbol of blending their lives together, they're now going to blend their sands together. Your marriage be like that sand, impossible to separate again. For as much as Stephen and Leah have consented in holy wedlock and have confirmed the same by the giving and receiving each of one ring and by the authority committed to me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I declare that Stephen and Leah are now husband and wife according to the ordinance of God and the law of the province of Nova Scotia. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, amen. What God has joined together, let not man put asunder. Oh, yes, this part. You may kiss the bride. Thank you. Let us all pray. Our Father, what a blessing to be here today. What a blessing to witness this precious couple commit their vows to one another, to promise to love one another through all circumstances in life for the rest of their journey on this earth. Father, we thank you that you have made marriage such a holy and sacred thing. We thank you that you have provided this so that a man is not alone, that a woman is not alone, but that we can come together, two, blending into the unit of one, and it is much better. As we have mentioned, Lord, I pray that Stephen and Leah will make the Lord Jesus Christ the third strand in their marriage, that with him, nothing can tear them apart. Unite them together in him, we pray, and we pray your richest blessing upon them in Jesus' precious name, amen.
Amen.
It's now my happy privilege and pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Stephen Holt.
Thank you. Okay.
Somewhere Alright, so first up, we're introducing the best man, Aaron and Jeremy Holt.
So Aaron, as we've all, is a brother of Stephen. He's very proficient at the trumpet, as you've all seen, has a music degree, and loves coffee. And
Jeremy there, well, the biggest Star Wars fan ever you might meet.
Next, we have Rhea Thibault. She is the sister-in-law of the bride. She's a teacher at Citadel High, and I think she's very awesome.
All right. Next, we got Laura, my sister of Leah as well, sister of the bride. She's probably happy to not have 6 hours of video editing after all this. Probably very happy to be sitting somewhere much nicer behind, in front of the cameras this time. Yeah.
And last, but definitely not least, the not-so-newlywed couple!
Right here, Timothy has made a very, very useful. How about you introduce it?
It's a list to help with your efforts in making the couple kiss. So first off, you can sing a song with the word kiss in it. So there's like, kiss me out of the bearded barley night. And if you sing that, they'll kiss. Yeah. I think I'm gonna get 5 here.
All right.
Actually, name a television show the couple has watched together.
Well, let's see. I believe there's a Doctor Who, isn't there?
Can't be used again. Next.
If you share a story about the couple, well, that might get you a certain kiss. How about?
Yeah, depending on how good the story is, how good a kiss you're gonna get. So if I just said, Leah and Stephen were born.
Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. It has to be better than that.
All right. We also have a series of questions.
Yes.
Which are all listed here. A series of questions that, for an answer, well, you know, there'll be a bit of a kiss right up ahead.
Yep. And then last, you show them how it's done. Wait, I got this.
All right, now I've lost my paper. All right.
All right.
All right, so the room is booked till 11, which we did forget to mention, but that's still plenty of time.
So the final rule, just have fun, have a good time, and I'm going to say grace, and I guess we're going to start having food. Father, thank you for this day, and for all the amazing people here, and for the love that Lee and Stephen have together, and all the people that are here to support them, and just be with them on the special day, and just thank you for the food, and in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. All right. Enjoy.
Alright, so we're just about to start the speeches, but before that, I just have one more kick. My original story earlier was pretty bad, so I'm going to try a new story. Leah used to go on these like Christian chat sites and just talk with people and stuff like that, and there's always like one or two guys who are always like trying to flirt with her, and so she talked to me about it, and So one day she was saying like, well, there's this guy who likes me, but I'm this is this, and there's always something wrong with them. And but every time she'd always say, there's this one guy though that, you know, he's super sweet and he's my best friend. And it was Steven. I was like, well, why don't you go with him? And she'd always say, well, he's my best friend, and that would make it really awkward. So I kept telling her, like, what, you know what? I think that's the guy you need to pursue. And one day I looked at her and said, you know what? Steven is the guy you're gonna marry. A year later, they started dating, and guess what? Called it.
I think they'd want to try and, yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Wait, so it's a story, you know?
What? Yeah, I guess so. Just say, well.
We're starting with Aaron?
Starting with Aaron? All right.
All right, so I guess without further ado, we are having Aaron to come up with his first speech.
All right, thank you, everyone, for coming, for my brother's wedding and for Aaliyah's wedding. It's great to see all of you here. If you didn't know, we're all from Virginia, so our family came up. Sorry, Stephen, that more of us from America couldn't come, but we're really glad to be here. I'm glad to see the city that you're living in. Glad to see your home, your new home with Leah, and it's been a great week being here. I'm sorry I had to leave tomorrow, but it's good to be here. So while I tried to think of all the things I could say about you, Stephen, I'm trying to remember things about Leah as well, okay? So keep that in mind. If you ask my brothers, Stephen and Jeremy, maybe even my father, one of the things that they will start to say is that I can tend to be annoying and get on your nerves and you know, just intrude into your every moment of your lives and really just become annoying. Maybe it has to do with being the youngest brother of three or growing up in a house with all boys. I'm not sure. or maybe it's just because I feel like you really need my help with my comments. Maybe it's not necessary. despite all of that, I think that, you know, Stephen, as my brother, you have really learned to live with me as I am. And, you know, I really appreciate that about you. And and I'm thinking about, you know, a few times where I've come to see you and, or you know, maybe you would come downstairs in the morning and I would notice that you just look really happy. And I would know that it's because you're thinking about Leah. You're thinking about the wonderful woman that you knew in Canada that unfortunately wasn't with us where we were. So I say, Stephen always had a shirt that said, I smile because I have no idea what's going on. I just want to say that today Stephen is smiling, and it's not because he doesn't know what's going on. It's because he's marrying the woman of his dreams. And because he loves her. The other thing I'd like to say is that Leah, even though I grew up in a house with all boys, you are the sister that I've never had. So, trying to think of a way to say this. Leah, you've found Stephen. He's someone who shares your humor. You've talked with him. You've shared your heart with him. But you've also come into our home in America. You've come, you stayed at our house. We would, I thought that, you know, Stephen's strange girl from Canada would come down and we wouldn't know how to converse with her. She'd be really awkward. And, but that wasn't the case with Leah. She was very friendly. She was very kind. She was, you know, just another person in the house. It's like she had been there forever. And even though I may have been annoying, she was able to fight right back with me, probably due to her wonderful brothers, Timothy and Thomas. I'm sure you had some of the same relationships because you fit right in with us.
Stephen, I want to say some of the best times we had together were actually on our way to school. We both went to college. Our college experiences overlapped a little bit. So I got to go to school with Stephen for a couple of years. And I think some of the best memories I have with you are, you know, just driving down the road in your old car with the music cranked up, listening to some tunes. And I think those are the times where we spent the most meaningful experiences. Some days we would just turn the music off and he would talk and talk and talk, and we would get home and we would realize that we never turned the radio on or listened to anything. And I think it's those conversations that we shared you know, every day or every couple days for you, every now and then. It was what you know, helped us grow together as brothers. And I think the same thing kind of goes for Leah as well, because even though you weren't here, you weren't part of my daily life, you would concern yourself with my life. You would butt in and concern yourself in a way that was loving, in a way that helped me along the paths of my life where I wasn't so sure where I should go. And I know that it was you know, God that was leading both of you through all of that. And I see it in both of you. So I just want to say that Stephen may have found someone who could live. We could all say that Stephen found someone he could live with for the rest of his life. And I would say that he found someone who has already been a part of our lives.
And thank you, Aaron. That was wonderful. And for our next speech, we've got the other brother, the other best man. We've got Jeremy Holtz.
Good evening. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Jeremy. I'm the middle brother of the three Holt brothers. And Stephen is my older brother. And I can't tell you how proud I am of the man he's become. I have watched him for 25 years grow up to be an incredible man. He graduated college with a degree in accounting and found a great girl, Leah, who has been, you know, a great part of my life as well. And I'm not even honestly reading this because I'm going off script here, but anyway, I'm very proud of you, Stephen. And one of my favorite things about Stephen is we both are huge baseball fans. And baseball is one of the, you know, biggest sports in America. And, you know, when we're together, that's all we talk about, like baseball. And maybe some Star Wars here and there and other stuff. But all in all, I want to talk about this little game Stephen and I used to play. It's kind of silly. But it would be like the middle of the night, and he would be in his room and I'd be in my room. Everybody was in the bed. And, you know, our beds were like literally, like our heads were like right by each other on opposite sides of the wall. So we were shouting, like we would just like talk loud so we could hear each other. And we would ask questions like, what's the world's biggest tree? And the answer was
broccoli.
Yes, broccoli. And then my favorite question was, who controlled Paul McCartney, or who controlled George Washington's feet? Yes, Paul McCartney and John Lennon. And it's just like a silly game we used to play at night. And sometimes we'd actually have walkie-talkies and we'd play it so we wouldn't make our father mad. Huh? And the other hilarious question is, what's the world's biggest mountain? And Chinese food. And the reason we say that is because when we had Chinese food, we'd put the food on our plate and it looked like a big mountain. So we'd call it the world's biggest mountain. And then, but Stephen has been there for me when I need him most, and Lee has been there too, and they've helped me through some stuff, and I just want to say congratulations to you both, and thank you for always being there for me.
All right, next up we have Laura Tebow over here, sister of the bride.
Hello. Okay, so first I wanted to say to Stephen, you're an amazing guy and only someone really special could be worthy of my sister, and you passed the bar, excelled way up. Yeah, I've been enjoying you being around, and I've really noticed since you guys have been married that you've both been very happy, and there's this like light about you, and it's been really good to see. I know a lot of people always tell these like stories about their loved ones, but I feel like every memory of me and Leah is kind of a good story. So I didn't pick one out, but yeah, every minute's been like a good memory to me. I'm so proud of you, Leah, and I'm so happy for you. And no matter what happens in my life, it will always give me joy to know that you're my sister and that I get to be your sister. Why did I look at you? I know I don't always show my emotions well sometimes, but watching you succeed in life makes me very proud of you. And seeing you become an independent, kind, silly, beautiful woman full of so much care and love is inspiring to me. You're the girl I run to when I need a friend. Give me a second. Why did I write so much? You're the girl I run to when I need someone to talk to. You're the girl I confide in. And growing up, you were the girl I would run to when I need someone to go shopping with or to do something girly. Because I was never really very girly, and I sort of learned it from you. It never really came naturally for me, but I love how we try and do girly things sometimes, and we do what we're supposed to do as like sisters and as girls, but it's still like our special thing, and I never want to stop doing that, and I'll never have that with anyone else, so you're like one of a kind. You understand me like no one else does. You know me, and I'm glad you do. You get me, and that's a really special thing because I don't think many people really do. I have a unique personality, and I have a hard time opening up to people and letting them in. I can be a bit of a mystery sometimes, but with you, I'm an open book. I don't have to hide anything from you. I get to feel completely safe around you, and I know I can count on you, and I can trust you with everything. You're always there for me, and that means so much, and you're always encouraging me to do the right thing, to be myself. And not let life get the best of me. I can't believe that I get to be somebody important to you. The fact that Leah Elizabeth Holt likes to spend time with me and that she saves time for me. She values my opinion, that she feeds me. And that she loves me more than I feel like I deserve. It makes me feel special. But that's just you. You make people feel special, and the people around you feel like they're cared about, and you make them feel like they're important and feel like they matter. You make the world a better place, and I find that amazing. The fact that you've taken it upon yourself to care for little children every single day is really admirable, because I'm not very good at it. I love you for your heart, and the fact that you let Steven into your heart means that I can too, and he's a really special guy, and I look forward to many years we'll have to get to know him, and for him being a part of our family. And I wanted to thank Steven for coming to Canada for my sister. I will be forever grateful to you that sacrifice that you made, and for her and for our family. It means the world to me to have my sister around. And I wanted to thank Steven's family as well, because I know that must be hard, letting someone go. And you have no idea how important it is for me to have my sister. Even the thought of not having any one of my family members around kind of brings tears to my eyes, so thank you very much. I'm also proud that you both live a very God-centered life together. You guys are kind of my role models for marriage, dating, and dealing with life, and so far you've done a really good job. You remind me that a God-centered marriage is the most important part of your unity. It's a unit of three. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. If you maintain a strong relationship with God, he is the glue that will keep you both strong and close to one another. If that part's taken care of, everything else will be taken care of. Stephen is a lucky man because he gets to spend the rest of his life by your side, and that's a really special thing because it's you. That's it.
So being homeschooled, this next couple has taught us literally everything. They've known the bride since day one and are definitely not as cool as they think they are. So let's hear what they have to say about the couple. Well, please welcome Mr. and Mrs. Tim and Carla Tebow, or as I like to call, Mom and Dad.
Alrighty then. Anybody else here nervous? I am. All right. Family, friends, relatives, and others. Your imagination. I would like to thank you all for joining us on this special day, and I hope you're all as happy and excited as we are for Leah and Stephen. We would like to take this opportunity to thank Dave and Maureen Holt for raising such a remarkable young man. Stephen's kindness and helpfulness always shines through every time we see him. I do, however, apologize in advance, Stephen, for all the times I'm going to bug you, tease you, trick you. Just who I am, it's all right. But you are a good sport, I know. Stephen, we love you and welcome you into our family. If we had to go shopping for a husband for Leah, we would head to a special store with a special room where we'd find the priceless items, and that's exactly where we would find Stephen. And that's exactly who we would pick, Stephen. Did I say Stephen's name enough? Yeah. Stephen. Leah. Leah, when Leah was born, she was all cheeks. Very beautiful cheeks, and she still has very beautiful cheeks. At not even 2 years old, Leah would watch her mother change her brother's diapers. And one day while Carla was in the kitchen, she observed Leah in the living room with her doll. Kneeling down, Leah had the doll in the baby change position and proceeded to clean the doll, put Vaseline on it, fasten the diaper, in the same way she saw her mother do it. At this early age, Leah was very caring and protected over her siblings, looking out for them and keeping them from harm. As Leah got older, Children were always drawn to Leah. They just love her. Leah loved children as much as they loved her. Taking her love for children into her adult life, Leah surrounds herself with children in her profession where she is known as Big Leah. Big Leah. Who calls her Big Leah? I guess if you're no taller than 2 feet, big works with Leah. But other than that, nothing is big about that girl except her beauty, her kindness. That's number 6. Is this what you're supposed to do? Like, it's your daughter gets married and it's like, let's make the dad cry. That's number 6 today. Her kindness, her faithfulness, her love, her dedication, her laugh, her smile, and the list goes on. Leah, you are a remarkable, amazing, and beautiful woman. Your faith and deep care for others shines through when you are around. You will be a fantastic wife and a mother. We cannot be more proud of you. We get so excited when you guys come over to visit. We love you very much. We want to know that our door is always open. Our home is always your home. Okay, so the next little part here is more for the 30 years and under crowd, because they might understand this. Some of us older crowd might not. It's kind of a little story of how they met. As some of you know, Stephen and Leah met on the interweb on a chat site where they soon became BFFs. Leah told her brother Timothy that she would never date Stephen because they were good BFFs. LOL. Leah soon liked Stephen more than just BFFs. Leah's cousin Jacob said to Stephen, BTW, Leah wants more than BFFs. Leah responded with GRRRR. Jacob then said, BTW, Stephen wants to be more than BFFs too. So they became more than BFFs. In 09, they first webcammed, where they both exclaimed, bonus. In Thanksgiving 09, Stephen told Leah, FYI, 831. Does anyone know what 831 is?
No.
831, it's one of those things. It's 8 letters, 3 words, 1 meaning, I love you.
Aww.
So FYI, 831. Leah said, GR8, TTYL. The next day, Leah said, FYI, 831. Stephen said, GR8, 8312, TTYL.
That's crazy.
I just told a story. So as we all know, Stephen is from the United States of America. And I just want to give a little quick history the way I see it between Canada and the United States relations. It's not that bad. It starts off really good. 1776, what happened there? The Declaration of Independence is signed. The most famous Canadian quote was formed. Take off, eh? And 2 million people leave the United States and head north. That's actually a fact. 1783, Treaty of Paris and the border between the United States of America and British North America, Canada, is formed. It is the longest border in the world and the longest undefended border. 1812, USA declares war on Great Britain and turns its guns on British North America, Canada. Canada then boldly pronounces its most famous quote, take off, eh? And so they did. Armed with shovels, rakes, bows, arrows, and implements of destruction, Canada defended itself against the American invaders. Being a very short war, the War of 1812 took place in 1812. 1867, Canada finally decides to make it official. They put the letters of the alphabet in a big bowl and drew the letters out one by one and boldly pronounced. C-A, N-A, D-A, and we got the name Canada. In 1890, Canada Dry is invented. It is nothing but dry. In 1909, the city of Vancouver got its first ambulance. Everyone was very excited. On its first trip, it ran over an American tourist. He became the first patient transported in the ambulance. 1918 and 1944, Canada and USA fight side by side in World War I and World War II, and we won, yay. 1951, Canada and U.S. build a line of radar sites to detect Soviet bombers. The project cost $450 million, and when it was completed, it was obsolete. 1972, Canada beats Russia in hockey. I just had to throw that in. That was... Sorry. In 1975, America gives us the pet rock. Millions were sold to Canadians and Americans. In 1980, Bob and Doug McKenzie quote the famous line, "Take off, eh?" In 1988, Prime Minister Mulroney and President Reagan signed the Canadian-U.S. Free Trade Agreement. In 2009, Canada gives us Justin Bieber. just saying. 2012, the pet rock became available again, prompting most people, including some Americans, to say, "Take off, eh?" Canada and USA have had a long and peaceful history, friendship. Many great things have come out of the two countries, but by far the greatest thing to come out of the Canadian and American relationship is the Stephen and the Leah. Yeah. We think you guys are just beautiful together and that you will accomplish amazing things. Now I'm going to tell you a story. The story of the three brides. Some of you might have already heard this story, but I'm telling anyway. There were once three brides from three different countries who married three different men. The first bride was from USA, and the day after she was married, her husband said, "Tomorrow, I want to see the dishes done and the floors vacuumed." The first day, he didn't see anything, but the day after that, he saw that the work was done. The second bride was from England, and the day after she was married, her husband said, "Tomorrow, I want to see the dishes done, the floors vacuumed, the bed made, and the supper on the table." The first day, he didn't see anything, and the next day, he didn't see anything, but by the third day, the work was done. The third bride was from Dartmouth, Nova Scotia, Canada. And the day after she was married, her husband said, "Tomorrow, I want to see the dishes done, the floors vacuumed, the bed made, supper on the table, my car washed, and my shoes polished." The first day, he didn't see anything. The next day, he didn't see anything. The third day, he still didn't see anything. But on the fourth day, the swelling went down in his right eye. He could see a little, but it was still hard to pee. Sorry, I threw it. Leah and Stephen, you are both wonderful and amazing people. We are so proud of you both. We can't wait to see how your love for each other will grow. You have the love and support of your parents, your siblings, your family, friends, and others. We hope that one day we will see some little stars and maple leaves running around. LOL. God is with you always. He will be there in your joyous times and in your dark times. Always remember God's word. It is a lamp for your feet and a light for your path. Thank you.
All right, so hailing from the lovely state of Virginia, we have Maureen, who is a nurse, and I don't know how to properly state this, fond of knitting, but I feel that might be an understatement. And then we have David, who is an avid sports fan. You can ask him what he does for a living, but he'll probably have to kill you afterwards. I'm not really sure. So, without further ado, please welcome Mr. and Mrs. David and Maureen Holt.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming here to see their wedding. We're excited to be here. It took us 2 days to get here, and it took us 2 days to get back, but we can do it. I don't have a speech. They should have went left. That was an incredible speech. That was really cool. Some things that, you know, I just kind of want to talk about Stephen. There were times that we didn't think he would that he would make it to adulthood. there was one time where he had a blood disease, and he was about 3 years old, and you know, we didn't really know what was going on, and we just noticed that sometimes we would be walking somewhere with him, and he would just say, I gotta sit down and rest. And we're like, okay, he's 3 years old, he needs to rest.
And he kept wanting to watch TV.
Oh, my wife said he wanted to keep watching a lot of TV. So we didn't know what it was, but I think, Maureen, you can probably tell the story better than I can, but we took him to a doctor that seemed to know exactly what the problem was. So I don't know if you wanna.
Just to put it briefly, it was a virus that caused his body to stop making red blood cells. So he was very anemic, and the doctor said we brought him into the hospital at the right time. So to make a long story short, he got a unit of blood, and you know, by 3 or 4 weeks later, he was almost back to normal.
And so somehow the blood transfusion restarted his system making new blood cells. But one of the things that we noted, I talked to Maureen, I said, well, so how do you identify something like that? So she said the doctor would pinch his nail, and if it didn't turn red after that, then, you know, that's how they knew. So for about 6 months after that, I would have Stephen come over, and I would just keep pinching his nails to see if they would, you know, turn red again. I don't know if you remember that or not, but the other time that we didn't think he would make it was he was running in the house. He says he wasn't running. He said he was walking. Okay, I think he ran down the steps, jumped, hit a piece of paper on the floor, twisted his leg, and broke it. And he had to have what's called a spica cast, and it went down one leg, all the way to his knee, down the other leg, around his waist, with a bar in between. And he couldn't walk. We had to carry him everywhere we went. And one of the things that we remember that Maureen probably did more than I did was we had a red wagon, and we would put him in a red wagon, and we would take him places. One of the places that we'd take him was church. So, you know, today when we heard your vows and how God-centered that was and how faith-oriented that was, you know, I think, you know, maybe we had a part in that, where, you know, because we took you to church all those, I don't know, weeks, months in a red wagon. So the other time he was probably about 11 or 12, and he played baseball, and he was a pitcher. He was actually pretty good, and we would practice pitching in the backyard. And so he would pitch to me, and I would pitch to him. You know, I would act like the catcher. He was the pitcher. And, you know, I threw the ball back to him, and he wasn't looking. So I threw the ball to him, and I could see that he wasn't looking, so I yelled, "Steven," and he looked up, and the ball hit him right in the forehead. He fell on the ground in the fetal position. He started screaming. And I went over, and, you know, he kind of laid there for, I don't know, maybe 5 minutes or so. And then he, you know, he got up, and he's like, "I'm okay." So we never took him to the doctor. He never saw anyone. So I'm like, Leah, if he's like staring, like, and not paying attention to you, then it's, you know, it's probably my fault. I hit him in the head with a baseball. So I want to say that we're very proud of him. We're proud of who he's become. He made it through college. I think he followed his dreams. He followed his heart to Canada. And I think we all knew that once he met Leah, or once she came to our house and we could see the interaction and how they interacted with each other, that was going to be it and they were going to be married. He even told me that. He's like, I'm going to marry Leah and I'm going to move to Canada. And I'm like, okay. And I remember one time my mother said, are you going to be sad when Stephen leaves? And I said, no. And I said, that's because he's doing what he wants to do. So I'm going to be very happy for him, and I'm happy for you. And Leah, we really enjoy your company. And like Aaron said, the first time you came to visit us, it was like you were an instant member of the family. And so you've been that way ever since. And, you know, we really love you, you know, like our own family. And we're proud to be a part of the TiVo family. Marie, you want to say anything? I know if you want to say, like, when they first met.
Yeah, I remember Stephen one night said, are you going to be home tomorrow night? Because I want you to meet somebody. And the next night, he brings me to the computer, and there was Leah. And I was just like, hi. And so, you know, I don't know how long after that, but he said, I want to go to Canada to meet Leah, and I want you to come with me. And you couldn't go. So my mom came with us, and, you know, we were excited the whole way up. And about 5 minutes before we got to their house, I was thinking, oh, what if this is a big mistake? And I was so nervous, and like, what if they don't like us? And when we got there, Leah ran out, and Stephen jumped out and ran up to her. And I saw Carla and Laura on the porch, and Carla had the same happy tears in her eyes that I did. And I said, we're going to be okay. And I've just gotten along great. And I'm so glad to have you as part of our family.
Yeah, so I see when Maureen and Carla get together, it's almost like they went to high school together and they went to college together. And, you know, they're just, I mean, it's like they're friends forever. Tim and I mean, that's like night and day. He's loud. He's always kidding around, joking. I'm more serious, more reserved. So, but we definitely get along, and we're definitely honored to be a part of the TiVo family. So thank you all.
So as Lee and Stephen don't really know this, but we've prepared a little something for them right before they get up and do their thank you speech. So we're just going to get that ready.
Across the way, I got a lot to say, but there's something about her, and you don't know why, but you're dying to try. You wanna kiss the girl. La 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 la, my oh my, look back, the boy's too shy to wanna kiss the girl. Sha la 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 la, ain't that sad? Ain't it a shame? Too bad he gonna miss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't be scared, we got the mood prepared. You wanna kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, kiss her now, don't wanna hide it out. You wanna kiss the girl. You gotta kiss the girl. Why don't you kiss the girl? You gotta kiss the girl. Go on and kiss the girl. Kiss the girl. Kiss the
is the girl.
Cheers for good.
It was just supposed to be a bunch of Disney love songs, and we got carried away at the end, but... All right, so I guess after this, the couple's gonna give a little thank you speech, and then we're handed over to the DJ, and we're gonna do the couple dances, and then y'all get on the dance floor and have fun.
And thank you.
Good evening. So we just want to thank everyone for coming. I just want to say personally, yes, I appreciate you know, everyone that you know, speaks to me, you know, coming here to be with Leah. It's definitely, it wasn't an easy choice. I'm, you know, thankful for my family, my brothers, you know, Leah's family, everyone that, you know, supported us through this. So I'm very thankful to be here, happy to be here. And some of you I don't know very well, but I'm very thankful for being welcomed into your family, and I hope to get to know all of you much better, and just to welcome me into your country and your city. We thank you again for coming and enjoying this day with us. It's, you know, it's a little not original, but it's a little unusual getting married twice, but we thank you. Thank you that you shared the day with us, and just, you know, made it special for us and all the memories. And we just, you know, we look forward to all the memories that we have with you in the future. Thank you very much. I guess also, well, we wanted to thank our parents that helped with, you know, all of the everything at the wedding. We have a friend, Leah Robertson, who made our cake.
And the cupcakes.
And the cupcakes.
All of the cupcakes.
All of the cupcakes. I can't name everyone, but there's just thank you to everyone that anyway that's helped with just making today possible. Mm-hmm. We thank you very much.
Can we have your attention, please? We're gonna start the first waltzes of this night. And of course, taking center stage right now, we have the bride and her father. So give a big, big round of applause for these two. For Leah and her dad. All right, we're gonna slow things down. This next song, here's a little Stephen Curtis Chapman.
Spins and she sways to whatever song plays, without a care in the world. And I'm sitting here wearing the weight of the world on my shoulders. It's been a long day and there's still work to do. She's pulling at me saying, Dad, I need you. There's a ball at the castle and I've been invited, and I need to practice my dancing. Oh, please, Daddy, please. So I dance with Cinderella while she's here in my arms. 'Cause I know something the prince never knew. I don't wanna miss even one song. 'Cause all too soon the clock will strike midnight and she'll be gone. She says he's a nice guy and I'd be impressed. She wants to know if I approve of the dress. She says, Dad, the prom is just 1 week away, and I need to practice my dancing. Oh, please, Daddy, please. So I will dance with Cinderella while she's here in my arms. 'Cause I know something the prince never knew. We'll be gone.
She came home today with a ring on her hand, just glowing and telling us all they had planned. She says, Dad, the wedding's still 6 months away, but I need to practice my dancing. Oh, please, Daddy, please. So I will dance with Cinderella while she is here in my arms.
Step onto the dance floor. This song is from Carole King and Child of Mine. Big round of applause for these two.
What is it about your touch that it makes amazes me so much. How is it that your sweet smile can get me through the hardest while? Oh, what's the magic in your eyes that brings the love in me alive? Oh, what is it about this dance, the sweetness of our romance, that makes me feel this way? These are the echoes of the Eden, reflections of what we were created for. Hints of the passion and freedom that waits on the other side of heaven's door. These are the echoes of Eden. Sky turns gray anytime you're far away. Oh, what is it that makes me sad anytime you're feeling bad? Oh, what is it about this night, the music and the candlelight, makes me feel this way? These are the echoes of Eden, reflections of what we were created for. Hints of the passion and freedom waits on the other side of heaven's door. These are the echoes of Eden. About this night, the music and the candlelight, it makes me feel this way. These are the echoes of Eden, reflections of what we were created for. Hints of the passion and freedom waits on the heaven's door. These are the echoes of Eden.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, give me a big round of applause for Leah and for Steven.
Don't worry, I'll save you.
You already have.
Off the shelves, I sit and listen to them by myself. Today's music ain't got the same soul. I like that old time rock and roll. Don't try to take me to the disco, you'll never even get me on the floor. In 10 minutes I'll be late for the door. I like that old time rock and roll. Hey, so like that old time rock and roll. Kind of music just soothes the soul. I reminisce about the days of old with that old time rock and roll. Won't hear them play and play the tango. I'd rather hear some blues or funky old soul. This only wash your way to get me to go. I like that old time rock and roll. Hey, know me or rally, call me what you will. Say I'm old fashioned, say I'm over the hill. Today's music ain't got the same soul. I like that old time rock and roll. Hey, still like that old time rock and roll. This kind of music just soothes the soul. I reminisce about the days of old with that old time rock and roll. Hey, rock and roll. Just soothes the soul. The days of old with that old time rock and roll.